Hey guys, Jake here. Today we're going to be going over how to paint your gun. We're going to be using my L96 bolt action sniper rifle, and the camo I'm going to be teaching you is snakeskin pattern in tan and brown. So, let's get into it. Alright, so the first things you're going to want to do before painting the gun is you're going to want to move important things, probably most likely the scope, and if you have a bipod, you might want to remove that, or you can spray paint them. It's totally up to you depending on what you want to get colored. And then you're going to want to tape probably the barrel, and you're going to want to tape the trigger area and then the cheek rest and the buttstock. If you'd like. Otherwise, you can just paint it all, but that's what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that off and I'm going to tape it up. Alright guys, so I've taped up the areas I want to tape. I've taken off the scope and now I have my rust-oleum camouflage paint. This is the tan one. So we're just going to shake that up real quick. Get that good and shaken up, test it out, make sure it's spraying well. Alright, now what we're going to do is we're just going to put on the base coat of tan. Give it a few finishing touches, get the bottom a little. Alright, looks pretty good. Now we're just gonna let that dry and we'll be back in a sec. Alright, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our brown spray paint. And what we're going to do is we're just going to do lines across the gun, just like this. All right, now we're going to let that dry and we'll come right back. Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take our mesh here. This mesh is just from a laundry hamper. You can use anything that has holes in it. It'll work fine. The smaller, I think the better, but pretty much whatever mesh you can find, see if it works. But this is what we're going to use for now, and we're going to take our tan again, our base coat. We're going to put the mesh over the brown streaks. And we're just gonna, not too hard spray over, but just give it a light spray over. Just like this. Just like that. Carefully take it off so it doesn't scratch. Put it in the next spot. Take it over here. Just lightly. The lighter you do it, I think it gives it a better effect. But whatever you want. A little bit right there. Oops. All right, so now we're gonna let that dry and we'll come back in a sec. All right, so another thing you can do here before finishing it off is you can take the brown again and just go straight over it with the mesh just to give it a kind of a different style. So that's what we're going to do here. And I kind of screwed up a little on the tan, so I'm just going to go over with it with the brown here. Give it a little more texture. But once again, put the mesh over and just do random stripes, and it'll still give it the same effect. Alright, now we're going to let that dry, and then we're going to come back and give it a little touch-up with the tan. Alright, so I've touched up on the whole gun here. Made it looking a lot better now. So the last thing we're going to do here, just to touch it up, this is optional. This is stylizing it with the tan, just giving it a light tan layer to kind of take away the popping out brown if you don't want the snakeskin look to pop out so much. If you do, just leave it. But if you want to make it look a little more worn, you're going to want to do this, which is going to be giving it a light layer of tan. So you're going to want to keep the can away farther than you usually would and just lightly go over the brown spots here. So, alright, well, looks pretty good. Let that dry and I'll give you some beauty shots of it. Thanks for watching. Hope this helped. Like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks. See ya. Where you can hide. It's gonna get